What's up, folks?
Hello.
So we're in Best Buy, seeing if there's any interesting tech here. Is Best Buy still thinking, you guys?
Leave a comment down below. I like Best Buy.
I feel like it's Amazon. Amazon all day.
Sure, you do it a lot.
Amazon all day.
So the reason we have like come into Best Buy is because tonight will be the first time in forever that we are cooking. You guys always get on us about our really bad eating habits, and we finally are going to attempt cooking. So that should be interesting.
It should.
And we're gonna see if there's any tech we can get here that can like assist us in the process, or just to have
make things fun.
Make more things even more fun. Yeah, exactly.
So Ari's been dying for a battery case for her iPhone 6. And they finally got the Mophie Juice Pack Air and the Juice Pack Ultras. Which one are you going for?
I think I'm going to get the Juice Pack Ultra. I mean, I need battery. I don't have, my phone dies so quickly, so.
So you don't care that it's bigger?
But is it thicker or is it longer, thicker? What is it?
We're talking about cases, people. I don't know. Okay, guys, so I think we've come to a decision. I think we'll go with this one.
We have seen this in another vlog. There's a vlog in, I think it was July or something, and we looked at this, we were so entertained by it, we were tickled by it, and now it's come up again. So, I like it, I think we should get it.
It should be fun to have in the kitchen while we're
cooking.
Oh yeah.
So, out in Best Buy, we found someone who recognized Judd, and they are taking a selfie. Awesome. Now I'm gonna go for that discount though. I'm just kidding. This is pretty cool. It says, yeah, you should be scared. Introducing the next generation of gaming. HP Omen. This is really cool. It's like has Beats Audio with it. That's really awesome. Has some light up stuff at the side. This is kind of cool. Look at that price tag though.
Surprisingly, Ari's been really into 3DS.
Oh, it's so good.
And Mario. She's
like a
12-year-old,
right? Like, those kids really like the 3DS.
I mean, it makes sense, though. Usually, people's introduction to games is, like, through Mario and stuff like that.
Yeah.
She's finally got her piece.
It's so good. I beat the Mario game that I bought weeks ago.
I beat it.
No! No! He said he wouldn't do that. He beat Bowser. He said he wouldn't take credit for it. And now he... Okay, so listen, guys, I couldn't do the Bowser thing, but I did everything else.
She did everything else, except for some parts where she called me over for help.
Anyway, so I'm playing it again because I'm trying to collect the 90 star coins you need to open the star world. So it's not over. You think it's over, it's really not. It's awesome. Hey everyone, so we are finally back home. We've been out
finally
all day, and we're finally home. We're starving and we're about to start cooking. And everything we're cooking is coming from that box.
And as you can see, it is from a company called Blue Apron.
So it's only fitting that I'm wearing an apron right now. I'm really excited about this because they delivered this right to our door. And basically, Blue Apron is a service that delivers ingredients and recipes and everything right to your door for you to cook. It's supposed to take like 40 minutes maximum. And so when they reached out to us to ask us to try the service, we figured...
It was perfect.
Yeah, why not?
You guys know we are terrible when it comes to cooking food at home. We're always eating out. Almost every day.
Like, the people at Tops know us. Like, we've had every single waitress at Tops.
So, we're gonna go check inside this box. Actually, get the unboxing knife here.
Oh, we're gonna unbox it.
Open this up and see what kind of ingredients we've got and see what we're working with.
I'm so excited. The thing that keeps us back a lot from, like, cooking and stuff like that is the fact that we have to, like, look up recipes. We don't know any of our own. And then go out and buy ingredients. But, hey, this does all the work for you. Yes.
Enjoy.
Oh, that's cute.
Of course you gotta refrigerate this stuff, but let's see what we get.
But it comes like with these things to protect the freshness of it. So like even if you're out at work and this is delivered, it'll still stay fresh, which is awesome.
Nice. So we've got some memos and some recipes. Cool. Oh, nice. They tell us exactly. Nice.
Oh, that looks good. Is that what we're making today?
I think so. I told you it was steak.
Nice. And this is a two-person box because obviously there's two people. It's just two of us. So they have a two-person or a family of four box. We could probably eat the whole family of four box.
You guys have seen us eat. We can do it. We're going to try and make some sense of everything we've got in here and get ready to start cooking.
And crank up the music. We're about to have a good time.
Oh, yeah. You got the JB Pulse So we're going to see if this is any good. We just got it just to play some music while we're cooking, so see how that goes.
Yeah.
All right, guys, so we've got our ingredients all sprawled out. We've got our vegetables, our meats, everything we need to make a meal. And this is actually enough to make three different meals here. Our package came with three different meals that we can cook. Of course, we're going to go for the sirloin tip steaks. Mm. But we've got other options here as well.
Oh, that salmon looks so good.
Yeah, so that salmon was over here. And everything is individually sealed, so we know exactly what every ingredient is. So this is actually really cool. Great for, this would be perfect for someone like me.
Oh, oh yeah, look at the back of this. Okay. So the front is the ingredients, and the back has just like six steps. Only six steps to make this. Like, it's unbelievable to me. So while we get set up, say hi. We're vlogging.
Say what's up to the vlog.
Say what's up, vlog. Shout out your channel. Go follow. Hello.
Oh, look at this right here. This is the little JBL speaker.
Oh, that's dope. Can they see it?
You guys can see it, right? Yeah.
That's awesome.
Vlogging, periscoping.
This is so cool.
All at the same time. It's
multitasking.
This is 2015. Welcome. Guys, so we are all done. That only took us like what, 30 minutes?
It took us 30 minutes to get this. This is awesome.
Check it out. So this is our creation right here.
Yeah, I feel so proud of myself. And this is only about 700 calories. I think it says 680, but all their meals are between 500 to 700 calories, which is awesome. And you guys know I am hashtag sweating for the wedding. So this fits right in with my meal plan.
So perfect. So we are going to chow down and eat. But if you guys want to check out Blue Apron, the first 100 viewers get two meals off their first order. So definitely check the link down below in the description and try it out. And I can't wait to eat. Ready?
Already started. And it is really good.
All right, guys, so just got the mail. And a new case came in for the Galaxy S6. This is a Spigen Neo Hybrid EX case. So I'm going to try it out. As you can see here, I've got a bit of a dilemma. I've got three different phones. These are typically the phones I jump between as my daily driver. iPhone 6 Plus, Galaxy S6, and the Nexus 6 over here. These are all cased up. I like to protect my investments in phones, so I like to put cases on them. As much as I love to rock them the way they were intended, the way they were made, it's just really scary when I might not keep these phones, I might sell them sometime, and I just want them to be protected. So I got myself a little case here. This is the Spigen Neo Hybrid EX. And it looked like the least intrusive of a case. It doesn't look like it covers up everything. The design will still be shown. So I like that. Huh. Okay. I wasn't expecting this. This looks like it's just a bumper. And this is a screen. This is a back protector, I guess. Oh, that's kind of disappointing. I was definitely expecting this to have a clear back, a see-through back, not no back at all, and a screen protector. So that's pretty interesting. Let me see what this is actually like when I put it on. All right, so here we go. I guess you put this piece on first. I wish I knew that this was pretty much just a bumper, kind of like what Apple came out with the iPhone 4. So now I know that these Neo hybrids are like this. I mean, it doesn't look bad. I like this. Looks pretty good. But the back isn't protected. It definitely does do the thing that I wanted it to, in the sense that it doesn't really hide the design of the phone. But it's not protected. Ugh. So I guess I'll throw this little screen protector on the back, and that'll be it. Not a fan. Kind of wish that there was a little bit more to it. But what phone are you guys rocking? I'm curious to know. There are so many new phones out. Which ones are you guys rocking? I really like the Galaxy S6. I like the Edge, but I don't know. I'm not
I can't pick it over this for some reason. The getting used to that screen was a little tough for me. I'm gonna have a video on that. On what day? What day am I having that video out? On Friday. So you guys will see my thoughts on the 6 and the 6 Edge on a video Friday. But so far, I'm really liking the 6, this more so than the Edge. Yeah, and I've also got the iPhone 6 Plus here. This is pretty much my real daily driver, I would say, because I keep finding myself going back to this phone instead of any of the other Android phones, which is really odd to me because I'm an Android guy at heart, but I'm just really loving the 6 Plus. The battery life is amazing. I love how it works with all the Apple stuff that I'm using right now. So there's a lot of synergy here with the products that I use. But yeah, Nexus 6, it's had a good run. I really liked using it especially with Android Wear. But I don't know, I think it's time that I put this away. Because I really don't see myself going back to the Nexus 6, especially over the S6. This one feels a lot more comfortable in the hand. I can use this a lot easier. And it's got this amazing camera. So between the Nexus 6 and the Galaxy S6, I think I'll have to go with the S6. It's not as hard to use, definitely a lot easier. But I do want to know what you guys are using. What are your ideal phones out right now? Oh, and by the way, guys, this speaker, it is quite the speaker. It's really nice. I really like all the lights and all the crazy stuff that it can do. You guys can see here that you can kind of change it up to do whatever you want. It's got a couple of cool features. Right now, there's no music playing, so you don't see it as interactive as it can be. But, I don't know, is it worth $200? The sound is pretty good. It's got a decent amount of bass. The sound gets really loud. So, I mean, it performed very well. You know what this kind of reminds me of? It reminds me of a lava lamp. You know how back in the day people used to have lava lamps just for like the design and decor in their room? This is what that reminds me of while having the functionality of a pretty good speaker. But it is $200. I would have liked to see this at maybe like $150 or something. $200 just seems like a little excessive. But it is a nice speaker though. That's my mini review of this thing. I don't know how long the battery life is or anything. I am getting blown up right now on my Google Hangouts. But yeah, this is a pretty decent speaker. Not worth $200, I don't think. Alright guys, so I've been messing around with this a little bit more. I actually paired it with my iPhone. Yesterday I paired it with the MacBook, the new MacBook. And I actually got a notification to download the app when I connected it. Now what's interesting about that is that this app has a couple of cool features that I didn't even know about. So you can download different kind of lighting schemes like this one. You can download quite a few of them. And then you can see a few different options here, which is kind of cool. So it's kind of cool that they, you know, have things that you can add to it instead of just being stuck with the simple stuff that you get when you first get it. So that's pretty cool. I'll give them some bonus points for that. Like I said, guys, the sound is not bad. It's pretty good. Check it out. You might not be able to tell, but it gets really, really loud. It's hard to show over video, of course, but it gets loud, guys. So for a tiny little speaker like this, not bad. And guys, you saw the new video I dropped with the iPad Pro case. Well, check this out. When I got it from Sunny, I got quite a few of them. 50 to be exact. 50 iPad Pro cases. I have to go and recycle these or something because there's no way I need this mini. I only needed one for the video, but I couldn't just get one. Had to get 50. So, you gotta find some way to recycle all of this stuff. But what are you guys' thoughts on the iPad Pro? I saw it in the video. A lot of you thought that it was gonna be kinda crazy if Apple came out with something like this because it'd be too big. I'm still very interested in seeing something like this. I think it'd be pretty cool if they go about it the way I'm speculating, with like a possible keyboard attachment or a USB-C adapter. Could be USB-C on both sides, who knows. So if you have it in landscape mode, you can still have USB-C over here.
portrait, USB-C over there. I don't know. But if Apple does that, that'll be taking tablets one step closer to fully functional laptops, just like Microsoft is doing. So that would be pretty cool. But yeah, that's about that. This is what I'm currently working on. I have to finish this up. This is the Wing Zero custom Gundam that I got last week, and the iMac behind it. This is that old iMac that I had before. I still need to get rid of this thing. I need to sell it. But yeah, I'm working on this guy. I need to finish building him up. I've got the head so far, as well as the body and the arm. I wish this RX-100 will focus a bit better. I think it's time I look into another vlogging camera, something that autofocuses a bit faster and better than the RX-100. This is just taking way too long. Now I got it, but it just takes too long. So I might be looking into another vlogging camera. But yeah, that's about it, guys. I think I'm going to finish this up. I've got a lot of videos to work on this week. This week is going to be super busy. Hopefully, I get all the videos out that I want this week. I have like 3 videos planned. That's a lot of work. So keep your fingers crossed. Hopefully, I can do it all. But yeah, that's about it, guys. Hopefully, you enjoyed this vlog. Definitely check out the link down below. Check out our sponsor for the video. And yeah, we'll catch you in the next one. Ari is probably off doing whatever Ari thinks she does. But till the next video, guys. Peace.